رسول الله صلى على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ثم أما بعد, we continue our series about the كلمات القرآن, the word from the Quran, and we last time we stopped at والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this beautiful ayat talks about again the attributes or the characteristics of the successful one, al-muflihun. One of them is وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ, and those who believe in what was revealed to you, Ya Muhammad, and whatever revealed before you, meaning all the other or previous prophets and messenger of Allah, كل أنبياء ورسل الله السابقين, and all the books, التوراة, الإنجيل, الزبور, صحف إبراهيم, all the books that all the messengers or prophets received, we believe in them. So, and subhanAllah, again, this is the beginning of the Quran. This is the first, after Al-Fatiha, this first page. And from the beginning, as a Muslim, as a believer, you say, I believe in what revealed to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم from Quran and Sunnah, everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Rasulullah, al-wahi, revelation, is either Quran or the authentic Sunnah from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we believe in that 100%. And also we believe in what came to the other prophets and messengers before Islam. And subhanAllah, this complement between Islam and the previous religions has a relation to what Rasulullah said in the hadith that people used to walk beside. He said, "Matali wa matal anbiya," the analogy of me and the other prophet, like someone built a house, a great building. And everybody walking by this house will say, "Wow, what a beautiful building," except this missing brick, labina. There is only one missing piece or brick in the building. And then, ثم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, فأنا موضع هذه اللبنة. I am the one, I am the missing piece, I am the missing brick, صلى الله عليه وسلم. So, the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only the last deen, that Islam. Of course, إن الدين عند الله الإسلام, but the Islam, and the general term, is all the deens, all the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the books, all of them, they came. And the bashariyah, the mankind, was like a child. Allah will send according to their knowledge, to their experience, a prophet will teach them something. And then, after a while, Allah will send another messenger to complete the work, to continue the work. So it is a process that took many years from Adam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it's a, and this will teach us something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was able to send Rasulullah from day one with Adam, and send the Quran with Adam, and send all the, you know, everything with Adam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for His wisdom, Al-Alim Al-Hakim, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gradually change people, change, you know, and this as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yurabbina, as a mankind, as a human in general. I don't talk about you and me, but the mankind, the bashariyah, the general people, Bani Adam, the son of Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gradually teach him something slowly, 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 to the time of Rasulullah sallam, where the bashariyah or the mankind became more mature. Balagu sin al-rushd, like a child who reached what we say in the taklif, like 13, 14, to be able to comprehend, to be able to receive the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is very important concept that Muslims we have. And this is why we don't insult, we don't talk bad about Torah and Injil. We don't talk bad about them. And actually our position, we have to be very careful when we talk about Torah and Injil. Wallahi, because some ayat, really when you read it, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you feel the sense of al-wahi, of the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our position through Torah and Injil, one of three. ما صدقه القرآن فنصدقه وما كذبه القرآن فنكذبه وما سكت عنه القرآن فلا نصدقه ولا نكذبه نبقى محايرين whatever the Quran approved, so we believe in it. So if something in the Torah or Injil that Quran approved and agreed with, we believe in it. Or something in Torah and Injil that the Quran denied, the Quran disapproved, so we don't believe in it. Or something the Quran didn't mention anything. So what we should be? Should be neutral. We don't believe or disbelieve. What we say we don't know. But we don't take a position, we become more neutral. So this is point one. The second point, which is help us in our life, whatever in business, whatever in community work, in any aspect of life. Many people, when they start to come and work, whatever professional life or community work, they want to start from scratch. They want to say, fire the old people and start fresh. It doesn't work this way. Huh? Because I believe in what I have, and I believe what before me. This is very important. When I come to work with someone in a company, you don't throw all the experience of the company in the garbage. You build on the experience of the company. You build in the on the history of the company. You learn from the old people. You learn from the seniors. And then, because the knowledge that you have right now is more improved, then you introduce the new technology, the new approaches. But don't underestimate what the people did. Don't make fun of people who are riding donkeys, because, you know, we make the bike to simulate a donkey. And then we make fun of people who invented the bike, because if we don't have the bike, we don't have a car. If we don't have a car, we don't have a plane. If we don't have a plane, we don't have a rocket or a space shuttle. Same with the phone. You know, you remember first time we have, many of us work with the fax, remember? We used to have a fax and, you know, and now, mashallah, everything now, you know. The first telegraph, and then the phone, the wired phone, and then now, mashallah, we have. So what we have now is because the ulama, the scientists, the engineers believed in what they had before. They started from the other people finished. So we are continuing the work that the people before us started. SubhanAllah, this beautiful ayah, it's a very good concept in life, that we believe in Islam and we believe in the old religions too that Allah sent. We believe in our time and our technology, but we build on the previous experience and history that our ancestors started. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us believe in our time and the time before us, and we use and benefit from both of them. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم.